Where are we going today?
Kanyakumari!
This is Kumari herself.
Rajkumari!
Yes, Rajkumari.
Princess Cinderella!
Hi guys! Welcome back to another episode of A Little Bit of Us. Today we are going to Kanyakumari, the southernmost tip of India. And it's only 17 kilometers away from our township. Anuvijay Township. This trip is special because another buddy is joining us today. And it's none other than Dianshi, my friend. My mom is planning to watch the sunset. But I have some other plans. I want to go horse riding and eat lots and lots of ice cream. Hey, where are we going? I thought we were going to the beach. Oh wow, this church looks so stunning.
This is St. Ignatius Church,
a famous historical building in the state of Tamil Nadu. This church was built in the late 15th century by St. Francis Xavier. The church is dedicated to Mother Mary. This church has a tower built in the remembrance of St. Francis Xavier, a chapel for Mother Mary, and a shrine dedicated to St. Ignatius. We prayed for some time and also we walked around this beautiful church. This church is located at Kurumpanai, a small hamlet on the west coastline of Kanyakumari. We are on our way to our actual destination, the Kanyakumari beach.
Wow, my. Look at the bluey blue.
The dark blue of the ocean and the light blue of the sky. Over to you, Mommy.
Thank you, Annu. Now let me continue with the rest of our story. Kanyakumari, the southernmost tip of mainland India, is a charming city which offers very unique experiences to its visitors. It's the only place from where you can witness Arabian Sea and Bay of Bengal merging into Indian Ocean. This place offers a spectacular view of sunrise next to the majestic statue of Thiruvalluvar at Triveni Sangam. But we travelled in the evening hours, so our plan was to view the mesmerizing sunset. Thiruvalluvar statue is a towering statue of the famous Tamil poet and philosopher Thiruvalluvar. It's located on the top of a small island adjacent to the Vivekananda Rock Memorial, and currently it is the 25th tallest statue in India. We are going to climb now this. Hello? This is the iconic view tower of Kanyakumari, a helical pedestrian ramp perched above the water with views of the rocky coastline and the beautiful sunsets and sunrises. Undoubtedly, one of the best places that offer the magnificent view of the clear blue sea and the never-ending sky that seems to meet at the infinity. This tower also gives us a panoramic view of the major landmarks of Kanyakumari. എന്റെ പുറകിലുള്ളതാണ് ത്രിവേണി സംഗമം. There are three oceans meeting at this point: the Arabic Ocean, the Indian Ocean, and the Bay of Bengal. Watching the sunrises and the sunsets on the liquid horizon of Kanyakumari is one of the priceless things to do here. The best time to visit this view tower is in the evenings, when we can enjoy the view of the setting sun on one side and the rising moon on the other. Now let's explore this small little town. Annu and Dia are in a mood for ice cream, but for me, it's as usual a tea break, along with the most popular snack here called mulagu bhaji.
Mm-hmm.
There are several fun things to do here in Kanyakumari, and one of them includes shopping at the stalls in this region. You can buy shells, handicrafts made from shells, painted shells, and products ornamented with shells. Mahatma Gandhi has visited Kanyakumari twice. After his demise in 1948, his ashes were kept in 12 different urns so as to transfer them to different parts of the country. One of them was brought to Kanyakumari. Before immersion in the sea waters at Kanyakumari, it was kept at the spot where now the Gandhi Memorial is built. The most striking feature of Gandhi Mandapam is its ceiling. It has an opening that has been built in such a way that on every 2nd October, which is the birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, the rays of sun falls exactly on the spot where his ashes were kept. We reached the Gandhi Mandapam. It's closed, unfortunately. Where are those sort of aram? To show you inside, what's inside.
Yes, man.
Mera.
Mera.
Mera. Yes,
nice to meet you. Kanyakumari is also famous for the 3,000-year-old temple dedicated to goddess Kumari Amman. It is believed that the nose ring of Devi Kanyakumari has a ruby which is so bright that it could be seen from far at night. According to locals, some ships sailing in the sea has mistaken this brilliance of the rubies as the light from the lighthouse and had got wrecked. Because of this reason, the eastern side gate of the temple is always closed. Kodavila njangala kore odi 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 avasaram ivide etti anna kutti priya kutti and me, finally we have reached. Angotte onnum povan entry illa, so we have to stop ourselves here. This is the nearest point from where you can see the statue, Triveni Sangamam, the sunset, and the Vivekananda Rock. The Vivekananda Memorial, built in 1970, is dedicated to Swami Vivekananda, who was one of the greatest social reformers in India. He had meditated on this very rock where the memorial stands today. Standing on another rock is the statue of famous Tamil poet named Thiruvalluvar, who lived 2000 years ago. It's said that the height of Thiruvalluvar's statue, which is 133 feet, is to honor the 133 chapters of Thirukkural, the classic Tamil literary work penned by the poet himself. Visit to Kanyakumari can mean different to different people. For some, it can be a place to relax and a beachside resort. For some, it's simply another tourist destination in South India. And for some, it can be a visit to experience the history of our country. But for all, it offers two priceless moments, a sunrise and a sunset.
Hey, I'm back. Now let's do some shopping.
Something for myself. ഇവിടെ എങ്ങനത്തെ നിറയെ കിടിപിടികളാണ് ഈ കടയിൽ. And Annu and Dia, they are confused what to buy.
I love these bunny hairbands. Bunny, 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 and it's so funny.
So Annu and Diya going for a horse ride. Enda pere kudirede pere
guru.
Guru, take care of Annu and Diya. Madile iranga ha
sir padukka nadathi vittu
padukka onnu nadathittu velo I will follow you. Naan kooda vara.
Now we're going tugboat, tugboat. It's fun! Thanks, Mr. Horse, for the ride. It was nice!
That's all for today. Thanks for watching A Little Bit of Us. Annu and Dia had a horse ride.
That was fun. That horse was fun.
This beach is truly a gem of Tamil Nadu, offering a harmonious blend of nature, culture and spirituality. Whether you are seeking solace in the tranquil surroundings or delving into the rich history and heritage of the region, this beach has something to offer to every visitor. Bye from A Little Bit of Us.